A teenager is about to start his senior year at Lake Norman Charter High School. But for the past few months, he's been getting treatment for a brain tumor. And while the tumor was successfully removed, the bills for his family have been adding up. Our Brianna Harper talked to the teenager's mom and also a woman who's now trying to help the family.
There couldn't have been really much that could have been worse on the table.
A family's worst nightmare. What first began as extreme headaches turned out to be a fist-sized tumor inside 17-year-old Brady McKay's brain. That was back in May when he was first diagnosed with glioblastoma. Days later, he underwent emergency surgery to remove the tumor, but doctors said it wouldn't be easy.
We have people everywhere that are really pushing and praying, and a miracle happened and that tumor shifted.
It did, and doctors managed to remove the entire tumor.
Double whammy of miracles that day and in the midst of what could have been the worst possible outcome.
But we're told surgery is only part of the battle. Now Brady faces ongoing radiation and chemo while his parents try to overcome mounting medical bills.
Life doesn't pause. Everything continues. So those bills that you have on a regular basis continue, plus much more.
Linda Arietta knows the struggle firsthand after her husband died from a brain tumor in 2014. Months after his death, she started Fight the Good Fight.
I wanted a way to remember his name and his legacy, and at the same time help the community.
Each year, Arietta organizes a race to raise money for families dealing with brain tumor struggles and to also raise awareness.
We have this incredible village that's kind of lifted us up and kept us going.
Starting with the support from the Lake Norman Charter School community and beyond. The McKay family says now their original nightmare has transformed.
Focus on the blessings in the midst of the storm and certainly fight the good fight.
Brianna Harper, Channel 9 Eyewitness News.
The fundraiser for Brady will be held August the 17th at 4 o'clock at 11 Lakes Brewery in Cornelius. And there will be a silent auction there to help raise money. A percentage of the beer sales that evening will also go to his family.